So that's really awesome. I really, really love this hero. It's not super relevant against Titan with the elemental link part to it. Hey, thanks so much for checking out the channel. If you're curious about any other hero in Empires & Puzzles, you can view my website at anchorgame.com. There you will find I've graded every single hero with a calibrated team of graders. This resource will always be free. Thinking about supporting the hero grades in the breakdown videos? You're welcome to donate. Otherwise, feel free to share this resource with a friend. I have my exclusive line group called Anchor Cove, where you gain access to myself and tons of other experienced players with on-demand information and resources. If that piques your interest, all that information is on the opening page of my website with a short video. Let me dive into today's hero breakdown. Hey, thanks so much for checking out the channel. Today we're going to be doing a brand new hero breakdown on Frieda, the chilly little polar bear, keep you all nice and warm, bashing out all the Titans for you. He's got 733 on the attack, 723 on the defense, and 1330 on the health. Average speed, has an innate resistance to status ailments that affect the attack, which is pretty sweet. I do like that, it's pretty sweet. Deals 290 damage to the target and nearby enemies. The target nearby enemies get minus 54% defense against ice for 4 turns. Dispels buff from the target and nearby enemies. Elemental Link gives all ice allies 46% defense against nature for 4 turns. This effect cannot be dispelled. So these specials are pretty bonkers. I really, 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 really like Frieda. Frieda's really cool. If you were ever wondering, this hero is just like Panther, but better. This hero is also like Evelyn, but better. So of the elemental defensive down heroes, Frieda's probably the best. This video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. It is a free massive turn-based dark fantasy RPG. To try this game out, all you gotta do, go to the video description, click on the special links. You'll receive 50 gems, 1 energy refill, 100,000 silver, and 1 free champion, Adjudicator. All your treasure is waiting for you right over here. Reason being is that you're getting the minus 54% defense against ice for 4 turns. It's super relevant, but it's also gonna go ahead and dispel the buffs from the target nearby enemies, and then it's also gonna give it so you have 46% defense against nature for 4 turns as the elemental link. So that's really awesome. I really, really love this hero. It's not super relevant against Titan with the elemental link part to it, but other than that, it's really awesome. So as far as Titans go, Frieda is absolutely essential. Reason being is she gives elemental defensive down, so you want to bring her in on red Titans, and the elemental defensive down defense does stack with regular defensive down. So what that means is you can pair Frieda with a hero like Grimm and it gives a ton of defensive down, or you can pair her with Athena, that works as well too. So if you don't have Frieda, you could use a budget hero like Nordri, which is a 3-star that just came out. That's personally what I'm doing right now because I don't have Frieda. So Frieda's amazing on Titans because it allows you to stack incredibly important against Fire Titan. So if you don't have Frieda leveled up, make sure you go ahead and do that. So she does get an A grade on Titans because of her elemental defensive down, super important for getting high scores. On offense, she does also get another A grade there. Reason being is that she's hitting 3 enemies with defensive down against ice for 4 turns. And there's a ton of other enemies that hit multiple enemies in blue, so you can effectively kill other heroes. You can almost kill 3 heroes with just her paired with another hero. So you want to make sure you stagger, you put the defensive down elemental first, and then you can do a regular defensive down like Athena after, and you're pretty much going to clear out everything. So I love her on offense. The only reason why she isn't an A+ is that she's not incredibly viable against Teleria tanks. You can definitely use her still. I know there's still a lot of people that are using blue against Teleria, but it's not its strong color. So unfortunately, she doesn't have an A+ grade there. But other than that, she's an amazing hero. I'm not really that stoked on Frieda on defense. Reason being is she pairs extremely well with other blue heroes. And when she's on defense, you're typically not going to have other blue heroes on your defense, so you're not going to be able to exploit the fact that she gives elemental defensive down for 4 turns, as well as the elemental link that impacts all blue heroes. So I don't really care for her on defense. Sure, you could use her if you don't really have any other options, but she's not really suitable for defense, and that's why she has a B grade pretty much throughout as far as a tank, flank, and wing. She is viable, she can be used, but I'm not really recommending it. An overall grade of B on defense. So delving a little bit deeper, when we look at the weekly raid grades, she does get an A on rush attack. Reason being is if you do have access to blue heroes, you're probably gonna be able to exploit the fact of her hitting 3 enemies, giving them minus 54% defensive down for 3 turns. And then you add that on top of a ton of other blue heroes that hit 3 heroes, you're probably gonna crush out the team very quickly. I really love her on rush attack. She gets an A grade there. On buff, her tremendous value comes from the fact that she dispels the buffs from the target and nearby enemies. So that's very important to notate that she dispels all the enemies, so really useful there. So she does A- right on buff. On bloody, she gets an A- there, mostly because she could be dealing a little bit more damage, but still, she's gonna be hitting them and crushing them all out. You're gonna be killing with ice, so she gets an A- on bloody battle, which gives her an overall grade of an A. Very, very solid hero throughout. Love her on pretty much all stages of the game, but I would say that she doesn't really peak on any of them. She does a lot of stuff really, really well, but there's not one thing that she does that exploits. So overall, I really love the hero, but her defensive grade is what brings her down just a notch, doesn't give her that A+ grade, but overall an amazing hero. So if you do like this content, please make sure you go ahead, subscribe to the channel. Also, like, click that like button. If you watched this video, obviously you liked it enough to watch it all, so just click the like. I guess Google, you know, YouTube, they do care about that type of stuff, so make sure you do that, and I'll see you on the next video. So when we take a look at what she does on defense, she doesn't really pair that well.